Auburn Blitz is now on the air. Your daily look into what's happening in Auburn athletics. With your host, Andy Graham, Brett Pritchard, Randy Lee, War Eagle.
Hello again, everyone, and good Thursday afternoon. Welcome into this, the latest edition of the Auburn Blitz. I am Andy Graham, alongside David Jones. We'll be with you for the next hour, taking your comments, taking your phone calls, talking about everything going on in the world of Auburn athletics. Thank you so much for all of you out there being with us today. A lot going on today. I'm glad to be back with you, David.
The band's back together again.
The band's back.
A lot has transpired since you were in that position right there last week. Goodness gracious. SEC championship. Baseball team goes and lays an egg in Nashville at the same time the basketball team's there. With the number one team in the country coming in today, women forced to a play-in game, which I thought was insane. I mean, we could do a whole show on the NCAA tournament committee, and every year they stump their toe, and Virginia proved them wrong again. But great to be back with you, Andy, on this beautiful Thursday, start of March Madness.
Absolutely. NCAA tournament starting today. Like you said, baseball going on today. Spring practice going on. A lot going on. As this time of year, a lot going on. We will start with spring football.
Okay.
You freeze talking about getting together. What am I trying to say?
I got a lot of intel on spring break.
Go
spring
ahead.
Training. Let me. I saw his press conference. Basically, he was talking about how well the players have bought in, taking the lead with leadership and all of those things. And that all sounds good. It all has to translate to wins on the football field in the fall. But I was encouraged. He was very complimentary of DJ Durkin, talking about how he had really made a difference coming in with details. And the thing that I liked, Andy, Hugh Freeze used the word demand about five times in that press conference. You know, as a coach, one of the sayings that I always used was, you get what you demand, not what you request.
Right.
Okay. And the Auburn coaching staff is demanding things out of these players and holding them to a very, very high standard of accountability. And, I mean, that's across the board, academically, being on time, doing what you're supposed to do on the practice field, taking care of your business off the field. They are demanding a high standard. And in this day and time, with players demanding money and making demands, their own demands, you have to demand back. And the Auburn coaching staff is doing that. Now, position-wise, still too early to tell. There was one telling quote, Andy, from Kent Alston, the quarterback's coach.
Right.
And he said, if we don't have a clear number one by the end of the spring, we'll take it into the fall. Okay, you can take that two ways. You can say, oh, crap, here we go again. Or you can take it like this. These other guys are still young. This is just me talking. The Auburn coaches might lock me in a closet for saying this. I still think they want to see how fast Walker White can progress. And right now he's kind of like a deer in headlights is the word I'm getting, just from everything being new, okay? So you can take it like that. So let's take this thing on into the fall and see if somebody else can take over the top position. If not, it's going to be Peyton Thorns.
So, or we'll go out and get a
true.
Throw the transfer portal.
True. That's right. That's something else that I asked. I asked an Auburn staff member. He'll remain unnamed. But Tuesday at practice, I pulled him aside and I said, Coach, how are y'all – portal's open. Now, for the teams that aren't in the tournament, they're in a pretty good position right now. How in the world are y'all managing the portal, getting ready for the tournament, figuring out who's going to be here next year and who's not so you can figure out who you're going to go after in the portal? And he said, man, it's just there's not enough hours in the day. So, I mean, and that's the world we live in right now. But you're right. We could go out and get someone else in the portal that we have no clue or idea who that is right now. So,
another thing that Hugh Freeze talked about in the press conference was he wanted – 3,000-yard passer, or could we get to that? And he thinks we can. And was to get back to the true RPO kind of game. Mm-hmm. Do you think we could get to 3,000 yards?
Ooh.
I mean, I don't know.
That's a lot. Andy, he did say this, too. I meant to mention this as well. He said, my teams have always been at their best when we were about 55% run
right.
and 45% pass, okay? A true RPO deal. Now, as far as Peyton Thorn is concerned, he will be much better next year if he is the starter simply because, A, our offensive line continues to improve, and, B, we had the top wide receiver class signed in the country
right.
this past year. Yeah, youth, yes. Well, except for Cam Coleman. He's a freak of nature. And I said this to a few people. I didn't want to say it too loud because, you know, Alabama fans, you know, they're touchy. But I think Cam Coleman's going to end up being better than Ryan Williams. I watched them both in high school. Yeah, Ryan Williams is a freak of nature as well. Cam Coleman is just a huge body with a lot of talent, and that'll all play out. We'll see. Ryan Williams may smoke him like a Thanksgiving turkey at the end of the day. But right now, Cam Coleman has stepped on campus at Auburn, and you can see the difference quickly. I mean, I've talked about that with you. I talked about that in basketball with Brett and Randy and Luke. You know, when you see that dude, Caleb Holt, for instance, it don't take you but about 30 seconds to go, yeah, that's him. He's got it. Same deal with Cam Coleman. Now, we'll hope the rest of those guys. Now, I don't Bryce Kane's on campus right now, correct? Okay. Malcolm's not, is he?
No.
Okay. There's several of those guys. Perry Thompson's not.
No.
Okay. So I've heard great things about Bryce Kane and Cam Coleman to this point. It will be interesting when Perry and Malcolm get on campus to watch that wide receiver stock continue to rise. So that's two reasons that I would still feel comfortable if Peyton Thorn was the quarterback next fall because of the offensive line and the upgrade in receiver. But there again, it's fluid every day. You know, we'll see what happens.
Also, the new schedule's out.
How about that?
For 2020. Five, so it's basically the reverse of what it's going to be in 2024. So, Alabama, Georgia, Kentucky, Missouri at home, away, Arkansas, Oklahoma, Texas A&M, and Vanderbilt. So, a visit to Oklahoma next year.
Yeah.
Not next year, but
25. Yeah.
Yeah, but next year.
Yeah.
Not this year, so that should be interesting. That should be a lot of fun.
That might be my away trip. I think we're gonna. We may have to postpone our away trip this year. Brett will be glad because we've lost every away game that we've been to in football so far. I'm off the hook with basketball because I went to Nashville.
I saw that.
Saturday night. But because we're saving up to go to Maui with the basketball team next November.
So. I think that would be a
– Yes.
That would be a nice trip.
Yes, we've never been. I got to start working on my tan here pretty soon. But,
yeah.
I mean, you think about the new venues like Oklahoma and Texas. Both of those places would be really, really cool to visit.
I would imagine there will be a lot of Auburn fans taking that trip.
Absolutely.
To Texas or Oklahoma when we go.
Well, Andy, I told Bruce at practice Tuesday, I went to practice, and I told Coach Pearl, I said, Coach, I can't make it to Spokane. I said, matter of fact, I can't even make it to Boston. So I said, you get to the Final Four, we'll figure out a way to get to Phoenix. But I looked online at plane tickets flying out of Birmingham or Atlanta to Spokane. $1,300 a ticket, round trip. Yes, flight, just flight. So I hope the Auburn fans that have got a little extra jack will make that trip and be very, very loud this weekend.
I hope so. Got to take our first break here on the Auburn Blitz, but don't go anywhere. We'll be back with more right after these messages.
Hi, this is Brian Weiss with Weiss Motors. With our all-star lineup of Dodge trucks, Jeep, SUVs, and Chrysler cars, we offer the area a team dedicated to making your next vehicle purchase a positive experience. Our sales team offers competitive pricing, and we back up all sales with service department second to none. Weiss Motors also offers the area's best selection of pre-owned vehicles. Visit Weiss Motors at 2133 Cherokee Road in Alexander City.
Heritage South Credit Union in Alexander City is your community credit union, and they have been for over 80 years. Heritage South Credit Union proudly serves Tallapoosa, Coosa, Lee, Chambers, Randolph, and Chilton counties. From checking to business accounts, to share savings to club accounts, to their kids club and investments, visit them online at myhscu.com. Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union for 80 years, federally insured by NCUA.
When you need an automotive hero, you got to call S&S Discount Tire Pros. With locations in Alexander City and Daville, we are here to serve you today. From quick services like oil changes and tire rotations to in-depth automotive repairs such as suspensions, brakes, and tune-ups, S&S can take care of all your tire needs. You just have to focus on what's important and love the drive. Call S&S Discount Tire Pros today. We are automotive heroes, and we are here to serve you.
WOTM is the television provider for all Alabama High School Athletic Association championship events and special programs. WOTM is your home for the Super 7 football, state finals basketball, baseball and softball state championships, the AHSAA weekly show, and WOTM also produced the first ever football playoff show, Super 7 preview show, and reclassification reveal show. Your exclusive home for all things AHSAA is WOTM. Contact your local cable provider to request WOTM to your channel lineup.
Whether it's Lake Martin, Lay Lake, or Logan Martin, boaters from all over the state of Alabama come to Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama, because it's worth the drive. With the best deals on unbeatable Suzuki outboards, Manitou and Landau tritunes, and a great pre-owned inventory while they last, Alex City Marine is the pros the locals know. And no matter where you're from, when you're here, you're local to us. Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama. AlexCityMarine.com.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our 9 locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
Don't know what you got till it's gone. Let's get serious. Let's get Arctic Air serious. You want your car and truck to live longer, don't you? Well, it's about maintenance. Same thing with Arctic Air. You see the number at the bottom of the screen? Call them right now. Let me tell you something. You want to be comfortable? We all want to be comfortable.
It's truck season at Glenn Smith Chevrolet in Opelika. Check out the powerful full-size and fully loaded Chevrolet Silverado LTZ, discounted up to $11,000 off, or the roomy midsize three-row SUV, the Chevy Traverse, discounted up to $7,750 off, and the perfect size Chevy Equinox up to $7,750 off. No payments until summertime. Over 350 new and used vehicles on the lot or on the way.
Get ready to smile.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Auburn Blitz. Andy and David here with you. We'll be with you for the next 45 minutes, taking your phone calls, taking your text, whatever you want to, however you want to consume us. We appreciate all of you out there being with us today. We are brought to you each and every day by Russell DeWitt Center, 9 locations around Central Alabama for all your building supply, home decor, tools, whatever it might be. Go and check out Russell DeWitt Center today. J.A. Smith Construction and Excavation gives them a call today. No job too big, no job too small. 334-531-0199. And Central Alabama Community College, great place to get a great education. A great education right here in Central Alabama. 4 locations: Alexandria City, Prattville, Talladega, and Childersburg. We appreciate all of you there again being with us. David,
a few comments, Andy, real quick.
Okay,
jump on
go ahead.
First of all, Jim Hardy, our buddy Jim, was letting us know. I got it pinned on my phone, so I've been keeping up. But it's 31-24 at the half, Michigan State over Mississippi State. And look, I changed my bracket this morning at 10:30. I raced Michigan State and I put Mississippi State in. And I hopefully they'll come back. They started out, and this is what scares me, Andy. I know we're going to get into the stats here with Yale and Auburn in a little bit, but this is what scares a lot of people when you team those jitters and you just don't shoot the basketball very well. Now, we have a couple of things going for us that can offset that. Maybe not so much Mississippi State. Plus, Michigan State, that is not known for the three-point shot, they hit 4 threes in the first 10 minutes. Izzo's over there giddier than a kid at Christmas. So, but that happened. So we'll hope Mississippi State comes back. Jeremy Scott always gives us his little Roll Tide emojis. Jeremy, this is the Auburn Blitz, but if that makes you feel good, you go right ahead, brother.
I think we got as many Alabama fans as we do Auburn fans.
Isn't that interesting? Mike Carlisle, Andy, very good to see you back. And it is. So, yeah, let's jump into some baseball now.
How about Connor McBride getting the start today?
Yeah. He's been the midweek bell cow. And let's just be honest, Andy. Let me go and put this out there. You know I'm the biggest Butch Thompson fan in the world. The pitching has – we're just not there yet. And we were hoping we'd get all that solved by the time we now, Tuesday night in Montgomery against a pretty good South Alabama team, we had 13 Ks and only one walk.
Yeah.
Okay. Excellent. against Vanderbilt. We got out hit.
Who started that game?
Herbeholz.
Okay.
Yeah. 47 hits for Vanderbilt, 25 for Auburn for the weekend. And we allowed 19 walks over the series.
Yeah, that's got to stop.
Yes, absolutely. So, and look, Butch will figure it out. He'll get the right guys out on the mound. The problem is, I think that's that robot that was built in a lab that's pitching tonight, the left-hander, Hagen Smith, 3-0 with a 1.57 ERA. He's the one that's probably as good, almost as good as that dude from Iowa that we saw. So tonight's going to be tough. And then, of course, Chase.
But you would expect Auburn to play better at home.
Oh, absolutely.
Obviously.
I think, you know, they put a tech post on Facebook this morning. Get there early, be loud. You know, tomorrow night's supposed to be the Eagle flight. I really don't think they're going to play any baseball tomorrow. The rain is supposed to rain. So maybe they'll play two Saturday. But we're number 17 in the country still at 14-6. Arkansas 17-2, 3-0 in the SEC. We're 4-3 in SEC home openers. I'll go ahead into these notes if you don't mind.
Please.
Under Butch Thompson. Five of those seven series came against top 10 teams. 10-2 at Plainsman Park this season are outscoring our opponents 116-54.
That's where it's got to.
Yeah.
I mean, the bats have got to.
Yeah.
Really pick up.
Well, that's the other thing that I was going to say too, Andy. You know, at the beginning of the season, we were just gangbusters. Cooper Wise's bat has cooled off a little bit. Ike Irish's bat has cooled off a little bit, okay? Now, you would expect that. When these guys get these elevated batting averages in the preseason, everybody goes, holy crap, he's going to bat 400 for now. Not when you get in the league, okay? So we just got to get those timely hits. We have some speed on the bases with Cooper Wise and with Chris Stanfield, Bobby Pierce. We've got some great speed on the bases. We got to get guys on base, move them, timely hits. But you already said it, the pitching. It's got to come around.
It'll be Connor McBride. Thursday it'll be Chase Alsop on Friday, mm-hmm. and Joseph Gonzalez. And you like you said, probably a doubleheader on Saturday.
Yeah, I would. It's the rain tomorrow. I thought they might go ahead and play two today, because there's actually a chance of rain Saturday. 50%, I think, but. Hopefully they can get those all in, because I can't imagine Arkansas staying into Sunday with them getting here starting on Thursday. So, well, there's our – go ahead.
Let's take us out.
Yeah, there's our music. So we're going to take another break. He's Andy Graham. I'm David Jones. Thanks for being here on the Auburn Blitz today. We got a lot more to talk about.
This is Kathy Holmes with Peppertree Steaks and Wine. Jeff Verner and I opened in East Montgomery 25 years ago and have become the premier butcher shop, wine retailer, and caterer in the River Region. We are excited to invite you to our newest location at 2459 East Glen Avenue in Auburn, Opelika. We want to become your one-stop shop for the freshest cuts of meat in town, grab-and-go casseroles, gift items, and the best wine selection in the area. Think of us when catering your next event. Check us out online at steaksandwine.com for daily lunch specials and details on upcoming wine tastings and fun events.
Late Mark Garage, located on Highway 280 in Jackson's Gap, has been serving our area since 1993. From routine maintenance such as oil changes, tune-ups, and rotating and balancing your tires, to transmission and engine repair, our trained and certified mechanics will get you back on the road better than before. Need a tow? With a 24-hour, 7-day-a-week towing service, Late Mark Garage has local and long-range pickup. Trust your vehicle needs to the professionals at Late Mark Garage. Call 256-825-6139, or better yet, stop in and see them today. Late Mark Garage.
What's the verdict?
Can't fix your heat pump. Need a new one.
Uh-oh. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking Daikin.
Call on Kevin Kill and Sunshine Heating and Air at 256-825-4849, Central Alabama's premier Daikin dealer.
So what's he thinking?
Oh, he's thinking Daikin.
Daikin, one of the top selling in the world.
Now I'm thinking Daikin.
Daikin, comfort for life.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
There's only one option for top-of-the-line aftermarket upgrades on your vehicle, and that's Frontline Outfitters. We offer quality parts, lift kits, custom wheels and tires, bed covers, step bars, and toolboxes. They're installed by trained and skilled professionals to custom powder coating with hundreds of colors and finishes to the highest quality film for window tinting using state-of-the-art film cutting technology. Call Frontline Outfitters at 256-409-8100. Don't be in the back of the line. Put your vehicle at the front with Frontline Outfitters. Grain and Leaf, located at 6068 Highway 63 South, is Lake Martin's premier boutique-style bottle shop with a unique array of sophistication for everyone. Appropriately named for its exclusive selection of top spirits, wine, and craft beer, Grain and Leaf also has a number of fine cigars for you to choose from. They also carry the full line of Hornsby Farms assorted jellies and pottery. Open 10 to 7 Monday through Saturday and noon to 5 on Sundays, Grain and Leaf is your premier shop in the Lake Martin area.
Lake Martin Mobile Detailing is the number one auto and boat detailing company in Central Alabama. Don't trust your boat or vehicle to just anybody. Hire the professionals. Top-of-the-line ceramic coating, detailing, gel coat restoration, and paint correction gives you the options to take care of your vehicle the right way. Located at 702 McCarty Road in Dable, Lake Martin Mobile Detailing will have you riding in style. Call them today at 256-794-2328 for superior automotive and boat detailing.
J.A. Smith Construction is your trusted choice for construction site clearing and grading for new home construction, underground utilities and site work, concrete paving, storm drain installation, fish ponds, and slough dredging. No job is too big or too small. Call Alexander at J.A. Smith Construction at 256-896-1400 or email asmith@jasmithconstruct.com. J.A. Smith Construction, your trusted choice for construction.
Registration for the 41st Alabama State Games is now open at allagames.com. Join us as we return to Birmingham for an exciting 3 days of Olympic-styled action June 7th through 9th. There are 24 sports offered and $40,000 in scholarships up for grabs. The Alabama State Games brings a mix of individual and team sports for all ages and abilities so everyone can go for the gold. Don't let this opportunity pass you by. Registration and event info can be found at allagames.com.
Welcome back to the Auburn Blitz. This is David with Andy. Glad to have Andy back with us today. Uh-oh. Ty Sanders' friend is talking again.
Uh-oh.
His friend predicts that Auburn will beat Houston in the national championship game, and he also predicts that Broome will come back next year. Well, I could be Ty's friend on that first one because I've got, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to go ahead and knock on wood. I have the Auburn Tigers beating the Houston Cougars in the national championship game. I have Houston beating Purdue and Auburn beating North Carolina. Call me crazy, but a four seed won it last year. I can't wait to play UConn. I hope we get there and just beat the stuffing out of UConn. But the reason that I've had a lot of people give me a hard time. The reason, look, y'all being a homer, okay?
Sure.
You got us winning.
A lot of us are.
Don't you? Yeah. Look, that's the deal, okay? We're deeper than anybody in the country. Somebody said that one of the pundits that said, you know, for every one guy you run out there, Auburn's got two at that position. We're deeper. Our defense is elite. Our half-court defense is elite. It's unbelievable. That defense against Florida Sunday, they had only had 11 shot clock violations all season. They couldn't find a shot Sunday, a lot of possessions. That, our depth, and we're just playing very, very well right now. Now, the ball has to go in the basket. Some things have to go our way. Everybody knows that. But and by the way, Mississippi State's closing in on Michigan State. Well, no, they're not. I thought it said 39-29. Michigan State, 16 minutes left. I don't know that Broome will come back. I really don't think so. You?
I'd love for him to.
Oh, sure.
And I don't think he's going to get – I know he's not a first-round draft pick.
Yeah.
He's probably not a second-round draft pick.
Yeah.
So, now, he just may just want to, you know, go somewhere, and he may just want to get out and spread his wings a little bit.
Right.
Fly. Yeah. But
yeah,
the way this team loves each other, the way they play together,
yeah,
he may come back.
Yeah.
If he does, I mean.
Well, and here's the other piece of that puzzle. Because I think the three portal guys obviously will all come back, Denver, Chaney, and Chad Baker. If Aiden comes back, and then you throw Tahad Pettiford in there.
Yeah.
If Broome came back, Dylan loves Auburn. Dylan might say, let's run it back one more time. Let's go. I mean, that would be – but we'll see how that works out. It's going to be interesting. All right, let's finish up baseball real quick, Andy, before we move on into these eerily similar stats between Auburn and Yale. It's crazy. Arkansas enters this weekend as the unanimous number one team in the country, 17-2. They swept Missouri. Missouri's not very good.
No.
Still, a sweep's a sweep. Offensively, they're hitting .287 as a team. They have six players hitting .300 or better. Nolan Souza is batting .355. And here's the scary part. On the mound, they lead the country in multiple pitching categories, including ERA, hits allowed per nine innings, strikeout-to-walk ratio, which was our boogaboo last weekend, strikeouts per nine innings, and whip. 0.97. So that is scary. It's going to be a tough, tough weekend. Very difficult challenge for Auburn. And like I told Brett, Andy, I think we all agreed on this. In the SEC, you really need to win two of the three at home. I mean, if you get a third, that's a bonus. And you really need to get one on the road, okay? Yeah. We didn't get any on the road last week. So we got to get one back on the road that we didn't get. Next week we can go to Texas A&M. Can we go 2-1 in College Station? Can we get two this weekend? I mean, it's going to be a tall task, but we knew that coming in. We know what this league, what six of your top 12 teams in the country are SEC teams. It's just unbelievable, the strength of this baseball. We talk about basketball. But baseball, the SEC, it's just unbelievable.
Oh, yeah.
Straight to
softball, too?
Softball as well. Softball. And is softball, I think softball's on the road this weekend. Texas A&M, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. All right. Let's get into these stats. The stat line between 27-7 Auburn and 22-9 Yale. Let me just run these down, Andy, and you interject anytime you want to jump in. The only stat that favors Auburn in a huge way is points per game. We do play a little bit faster pace. We average 83.3 points a game. Yale's at 75.2. Listen to this. Points allowed 68 by Auburn, 66.6 by Yale. Free throw percentage, we're – I'm sorry, field goal percentage. We're at 47.5. They're at 47.
Yeah.
3-point. 35.2 for us. 34.7 for them. That's unbelievable how close we are in our shooting percentages.
We get to the line a lot more.
We do.
Free throw line. That's, yep. That may be the difference. Again, they play in a much different conference than we do.
We're going to break that down, too, when we come back. There's the music. We got another break. We got a lot more to talk about with this basketball matchup coming up against Yale tomorrow. Come back and see us in just a minute.
Of nurses say they went into the profession because they wanted to help patients. No matter the reason you decided to become a nurse, you have all the tools needed to advance your degree at Jacksonville State University. Our Master's in Nursing program is now offered fully online and can be completed in less than 2 years. You can customize a flexible course schedule so you can receive your advanced education degree all while working on the front lines. JSU Nursing, your opportunity to advance your career and serve your community.
Egg rolls are back at Zaxby's. They're hand-rolled and come with a delicious sweet and spicy dipping sauce.
But enough from me. Let the egg rolls do the talking. And there you have it. 2 for $3 egg rolls. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's.
At C&T Electric, our clients are our priority. For the safety and security of your family and home, our technicians are professionally trained, drug tested, background checked, and wear uniforms with name tags. We're proud to have served the Elk City, Dadeville, and Lake Martin areas for the past 10 years. Give us a call at 256-234-0007 for all your electrical service and repair needs. Or visit us on the web at www.cntelectricllc.com and spell out the word and.
WOTM is the television provider for all Alabama High School Athletic Association championship events and special programs. WOTM is your home for the Super 7 football, state finals basketball, baseball and softball state championships, the AHSAA weekly show, and WOTM also produced the first ever football playoff show, Super 7 preview show, and reclassification reveal show. Your exclusive home for all things AHSAA is WOTM. Contact your local cable provider to request WOTM to your channel lineup.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our 9 locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
Bucks Island is your boating headquarters. Are you ready to hit the water and go boating this summer? Bucks Island has all kinds of boats, with one sure to fit exactly what you want. Fishing boats, sport boats, pontoon boats, and all with low monthly payments. Call 1-800-I'M-READY. Bucks Island Service Department experts are also here for you to keep your boat in top running condition. Call 1-800-I'M-READY. Don't be left standing on the bank this summer. Visit online at bucksisland.com. And don't buy a boat till you get a Bucks quote.
Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation is coming soon to the corner of 280 and 49 North in Dadeville. This new 10,000 square foot facility is conveniently located to serve the residents of the Lake Martin area and its many communities. A branch of Frederick Dean Funeral Home and Crematory in Opelika, Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation looks forward to serving your families and your communities, as we have since 1900 at Frederick Dean. 256-750-0381.
Fried chicken and wontons and teriyaki glaze and an egg roll. Some people think the Zaxby's Sensation Salad is too delicious to be a salad.
Yep, that's why we call it a salad. The Zaxby's Sensation Salad. Zaxby's.
Welcome back to the Auburn Blitz, David and Andy today. We got Terry on the line. Terry, before we get to you, I want to mention Pepper Tree Steak and Wines, our new sponsor. I don't have the specials in front of me today, but I can guarantee you whatever it is, it's going to be delicious.
That's true.
You walk into that, you know, we kid about Russell DeWitt Center being a man's paradise. You walk in there and you can just stay for an hour, you know, and you walk in Pepper Tree and you can stay for a while. I mean, it is, and if you're a foodie like I am, JJ and I were talking about that because he's a foodie too. You're a foodie.
I am.
As a matter of fact, and that place is unbelievable. So y'all make sure and visit our new sponsor, Pepper Tree Steak and Wines in Auburn, Alabama. 2 o'clock, it starts their daily specials. You don't have to cook tonight. The NCAA tournament's on all day. Get you some food from Pepper Tree. Just get in the house, turn the TV on. You're good to go. Now, I'm going to be in Plainsman Park tonight, so I'll be watching some games on my phone. But we appreciate Pepper Tree Steak and Wines. Let's go to the phone lines. We got our good buddy Terry waiting to chat at us. Terry. Oh, Jerry. It's not Terry. It's Jerry. Jerry, how you doing, brother?
I'm doing great, David and Andy. How about you guys?
Doing well.
Doing fine.
Good, good. Andy, it's good to see you back up in the saddle, buddy. Glad you're back with us.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome, man. And you're always in our thoughts and prayers, buddy. All of you are. But, David, you was reading off some of those stat lines about Arkansas's pitching, and that is some strong, strong stuff there. Y'all know that pitching is good, dominating pitching is so much a part of baseball, whether it's on or off that day or whatever. Pitching is just key, and that's going, you know, that's tough to deal with. But I hope our pitching can get settled down and straightened out and in the future. And I'm just going to mention a couple of things real quick, too, as far as football goes. I have thought for a while that in the end I think it's going to be the kid from Arkansas is our quarterback, White. I think Hugh Freeze had commented a couple of times in the past that he thought when they signed him, when they got him during the recruiting process, that he could do everything that they wanted to do. He was what they were looking for. And I just feel like with him coming in as a freshman, it's a lot different than what it used to be by him being able to go through spring training and so forth. And besides that, being acclimated with the campus and classes and all that it's just such an advantage. But and he was instrumental in helping us recruiting some of these young receivers, young guys, that I feel like he's going to be the guy sooner or later. I mean, either at the start of the season or some point during the season, I feel like I think he's going to be our guy at quarterback, and that's just kind of the way I'm reading it and feeling it. So we'll see about that, but also good luck to our basketball team. I'm pumped up about that, and I'm thinking, too, that some of these guys that may be coming back to our team next year, we'll see about that, but good luck to them in the future, and thank y'all for taking my call. War Eagle guy.
Appreciate it.
War Eagle, Jerry. Jerry, I agree with you. I disagree with the timeline. I do agree that I think Walker White's going to be the guy, Andy. I don't know that it's going to be this season.
They always talk about freshmen coming in and their head spinning.
Yeah.
Well, you take care of this during the spring.
Right.
And maybe really has a chance to compete in the fall.
Well, I just know this right now, and you can read into this what you want to. There's 4 quarterbacks in drills. He's the 4th guy. Of course, because you got Hank Brown and Gariner that have been on campus. So, naturally, he's not just supplanting one guy in Peyton Thorne. He's going to have to jump ahead of 3 guys, Hank Brown and Holden Gariner. I don't see that happening before the season. I just don't.
I thought I'd read somewhere that Walker White was kind of bumping up to the 2 spot.
I hadn't read that. I'll have to go check. I hope so. I do think he's the future. I do agree, Jerry. Everything I've read, it's just been a learning curve, which you would expect. But you know what? We'll see. We'll see how that works out. A couple more comments. Ty's got Auburn beating Kentucky in the championship. good Lord, that would be nuts. He's got Auburn beating Arizona, Kentucky beating Creighton. I don't see Arizona or Kentucky making it to the Final Four. That's just me. What do I know? Like I've told y'all before, don't take me to Vegas. You'll lose money. But I think Kentucky's going to stumble somewhere along the way. All right, let's get back into it because we didn't finish these basketball stats. And, Jerry, the other thing you said about the Arkansas pitching statistics, that's frightening. Yeah. Frightening. So we're going to have to hit the ball this weekend. You made the point, Andy, that we do score more than they do, and we go to the line a lot more than they do. Hopefully that's the case as well tomorrow at 3:15. But here's another one. Regardless of the especially since they play slower, 37.9 rebounds per game for us, 37.1 rebounds for them. Of course, the guy's 7-1, I think, their post player. 18 assists per game for us, 15 for them. That's a 3 advantage for us. Turnovers, basically the same, 9.5 for them, 10.5 for us. We force 2 more turnovers a game than they do. We score 3 more points per game off of turnovers. And obviously we block 3 more shots a game than they do, and 1.5 more steals. But when you look at just pure numbers, and a lot of people are, you know, into this analytics and the data, you know, other than points scored, we're pretty even with them. Now, you made the point, true, they play in the Ivy League. What would these numbers look like if they played in the SEC? And, Andy, here's another, you know, Brett and I had talked about this earlier in the year, and there was a stretch in the year where we were scratching our heads a little bit. But, you know, there's a false narrative out there. A buddy of mine was making fun of my bracket. He said, yeah, Auburn's not playing in Neville Arena. Stephen Pearl, there's a website, Andy, that averages out rankings by neutral and away games. Neutral site games this year, we're number 4 in the country. Neutral and away games combined, we're still the 13th ranked team in the country. So the old Auburn can't win on the road narrative, not so much.
How about that?
I loved that. We got to take one more break, and then we'll be back for our final segment here on the Auburn Blitz. David and Annie, thanks for being with us today.
When drinking, take a sober ride home, not someone's life. Alabama has a code of the road, and knowing it helps you follow it. This is a message from your Alabama Department of Transportation.
J.A. Smith Construction is your trusted choice for construction site clearing and grading for new home construction, underground utilities and site work, concrete paving, storm drain installation, fish ponds, and slough dredging. No job is too big or too small. Call Alexander at J.A. Smith Construction at 256-896-1400 or email asmith@jasmithconstruct.com. J.A. Smith Construction, your trusted choice for construction.
Sign Source is your local vendor for commercial and residential sign manufacturing and installation. We offer all kinds of lighted and non-lighted signage, from retail signs, LED message centers, event banners, vehicle wraps, the whole spectrum. We also offer service and repair on existing signs, as well as retrofitting to LED or installation of outsourced signage. We have the knowledge necessary to fulfill all of your signage needs in the short or long term. Visit signsourcenow.com to get started.
EnviroCare is the standard in East Central Alabama for all your pest control and termite needs. EnviroCare exclusively offers Centricon termite colony elimination system that is the industry's most effective termite control to protect your home year-round. The EnviroCare team's service is also the standard for our customers. From eliminating home pests to superior termite control, nobody cares like EnviroCare, serving Lake Martin and East Central Alabama.
Chick-fil-A is always the best option when you're on the go, but they are also great when it comes to planning your next event. From
tailgating to birthday parties to weddings. Call Chick-fil-A Alexander City at 256-289-7955 for catering or order on the Chick-fil-A app. Make sure to choose the Alexander City location and have your catering order ready to go. Nugget trays, mac and cheese trays, fruit trays, cookie trays, gallons of our famous lemonade or tea, and chilled grilled chicken sub sandwiches, and a lot more options. Make it Chick-fil-A Alexander City for your next event.
Folks around these parts have known for a long time that Walls Tire, just a mile past the bridge on Highway 280, is your number one stop for automotive service and repair. At Walls Tire, you'll always find quality service at a fair price on everything from AC, name brand tires, big or small repairs, routine maintenance, towing, and more. When your car or truck needs to run right, there's one place in the area to go, conveniently located and easy to find. Walls Tire, just a mile past the bridge on Highway 280.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
Catch a ride, not a buzz.
Hey, can you come get me?
Being buzzed still counts. Alabama has a code of the road, and knowing it helps you follow it. This is a message from your Alabama Department of Transportation.
Welcome back to the Auburn Blitz again, Andy and David. The madness has started. Started at 11:15 this morning. And of course, my very first pick is going to be down the tubes with Michigan State up by about 14.
Mine too.
Over Mississippi State. Duquesne is beating BYU. I picked BYU, as did you.
Creighton. That's got to be early too.
Yes, though. It's early, 38-30. Creighton is only beating Akron by two.
I picked Creighton to go
Elite Eight.
Yeah. Dayton's going to hurt.
I did too.
If that one is an upset.
Oh, that's real early, Andy. We still got hope. Jim Hardy wanted to know who's in our Final Four. Jim, I have the Auburn Tigers beating North Carolina Tar Heels, and I have the Houston Cougars beating the Purdue Boilermakers. And I know everybody's saying, but Houston got blown out. Yeah, that was a wake-up call. Probably a wake-up call for Tennessee as well.
Yeah.
And Kentucky in the SEC tournament, possibly even Alabama. Sometimes losing that game in the conference tournament lights a new fire. And you have Auburn.
I had Auburn, Houston. I had North Carolina and who was the other one?
Creighton.
Creighton.
Creighton or Purdue?
I had Purdue.
Purdue. So you had the same Final Four I did.
I did.
Great minds think alike. We'll see how that shakes out in a couple of weeks.
If I had them, don't pick those. It's a little too late for everybody, I guess.
Mike said, I don't see Mike's comment. It's something about maybe we end up playing Alabama again. And Jim Hardy said, Mike Carlisle, probably not. They don't play defense. Usually those teams lose out of the tournament by the second, third round. Look, Alabama's got a cakewalk to the Sweet 16. That's just my opinion. Now, Charleston is just like Alabama. They play at a frenzy. They shoot a lot of threes. That's going to be a shootout at the OK Corral. I don't think the Grand Canyon or St. Mary's can even athletically stay on the floor with Alabama. The key is the ball going in the basket for Alabama.
Like a lot of people, I got Samford upsetting Kansas.
I do, too. I have a Samford-McNeese State matchup in round two. I'd just love to see that. I think that would be fantastic. But so Andy and I are like-minded on our Final Four picks. So let's go down through our SEC people. Kentucky versus Oakland.
Cakewalk.
Yeah, that's today at 6 o'clock. Mississippi State, Michigan State is on right now. That one's all but done. Samford, 25-5. Kansas, 23-10. Look, I think we all have a little bit of Bill Self fatigue, Kansas fatigue. I've always respected that program. I worked a basketball camp at Kansas when Roy Williams was the coach, and I was in Allen Fieldhouse for a week, and it was one of the most unbelievable experiences of my life. There's a lot of tradition there.
Kansas is not the team that they have been in the past.
No, and they're
– at least the last couple of years.
No, that's right. 10 losses, when's the last time that happened? Plus, their leading scorer is out.
Right.
Samford plays 10 players just like we do. They all shoot the three just like we do. And they run, and it's in that high altitude, Salt Lake City. I got Samford, and I know you do too, and a lot of people do. Here's one that I picked, South Carolina, but I just think that's going to be a rock fight, as they say, South Carolina versus Oregon at 3 o'clock today on TNT. Tennessee, St. Peter's. Is Sister Jean still with St. Peter's?
I don't know.
I don't know. They're still working those rosary beads. Sister Jean, that was a Cinderella story a couple of years ago.
Okay.
Coming out of nowhere. And so
it all depends on how Connect plays.
Exactly.
That's going to carry Tennessee or not.
That's the disconnect.
Yeah.
I'll be here all week. Texas A&M, I love Buzz. They've got Nebraska. That's going to be a toss-up game, in my opinion. I hope A&M can come out on top. Florida versus Colorado State, who just pummeled Virginia. It was lovely. I enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I don't remember if Virginia double-dribbled, but and Andy, I know that – is it Handloggin? How do you pronounce the young man's name that had the horrific injury?
I don't know.
Okay, obviously he's not with them. But this is a dangerous Florida team.
Sure.
And then this Aberdeen guy comes out of nowhere in the tournament, has a great tournament.
Can UAB upset San Diego State?
Yes, they can. And I'll say this, that game, should we advance, either one of these teams scares me on any given day. Andy Kennedy, I think he set some kind of record for wins in Bartow over a particular stretch with Andy. And that's over Coach Gene Bartow's tenure.
Yeah.
Andy, of course, he was one of my classmates at UAB. I love Andy Kennedy. They're playing well. San Diego State, who was in the Final Four last year.
Right.
Andy, not exactly the same crew of characters. They've lost 10 games. But I picked San Diego State. I'm a UAB alum. They're probably going to disown me. I wanted to pick UAB so bad, but a UAB-Auburn matchup scares me to death. They'd be so up for that one. And then, of course, the women, Auburn versus Arizona in Stores, Connecticut. Play-in game. Imagine that. 6 o'clock tonight on ESPN2. But you know what? Congratulations to the Auburn women, because Coach Johnny, 10 wins the first year, and then maybe was it 15, 16 last year, and then 20 this year. Year three of the Johnny Harris era. They're moving on up, as they say. So very, very happy for the women. And we wish them the best of luck. And of course,
I think Syracuse, that's who you play to get into this.
Is that right?
I think
so. Syracuse first round. Okay. So, hey, guys, whatever you got planned this weekend, I hope you got the remote control in your hand and it doesn't blow up from you changing the channel, watching all these phenomenal basketball games. We'll be back again with you tomorrow. This is Thursday, right?
This is Thursday.
Be back tomorrow with you here on the Auburn Blitz. Thanks for tuning in today. Enjoy March Madness. For Andy, this is David Jones. We'll see you guys soon.